Hey guys, welcome to the second lesson. So we're going to continue where we left off from the previous lesson. So with our freeform surveys we generated before. And let me start on a new line so the definition doesn't get too stretched. So let me insert a surface component, link in our surface, and let's set the wire to hidden so we don't have spaghetti. Let's move it to here. Nice. Turn this one off. So let me show you the reason why we're going to use Lunchbox, because it's a really nice set of tools and components that will help us a lot, especially with the penalization. I mean, we could do it ourselves, but it would take some time and it would be a little bit tedious. But why waste time if Lunchbox already has a perfectly set of penalization components? So there are various, as you can see here, there's diamonds, hexagons, quads, whatever. And we're going to use triangle panels B. And that's it. So you just connect your surface to the surface input. And there you go. We already have our panels. So let's insert two number sliders set to integers so we can control the U and the V amount of panels. So let's copy this one over. If you double click on the canvas and you type in a number and you hit enter, you get like a nice number slider, as you've seen me do before. If you put two slashes, forward slashes, you get a panel. So here you can put some text. It will insert that automatically in a panel. So it's nice. It's a little bit faster. So let me set the number of panels so we have a little bit more clear what's happening on the surface. Not too much, as it gets slow. Something like this. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to convert all these panels to a mesh. And the reason we're going to switch to a mesh is because it will run faster. And also it has to do with, we're going to use Kangaroo later on to relax our panels. And Kangaroo works so much better if you use a mesh as an input, let's say. So let's do that. So we're going to use the mesh component. It's under the mesh tab and this one, construct mesh. So what does it need? It needs vertices, faces, and color. We're not going to do color for now, but the vertices and the faces, yes. We need to get the corner points from our surfaces. So there's a nice component called discontinuity. This will get the edges of the, the discontinuities in the edge curves from the panels. Which nicely spits out 3 points per panel. So these goes in the V. And for the F, because now it turns orange because the default is set to a quad panel, but we need a triangular panel. So we just need to insert the mesh triangle. And that's it. So now we have converted our surfaces to meshes. So the next thing is to weld and flatten that list. And here Weaverbird comes in handy. So we go to the Weaverbird tab and let's see where it is. It's here. Weaverbird join mesh and weld. Now don't forget to flatten the input. So all meshes get welded together. And we need to set the W to true because you want to weld the vertices. So let me insert a toggle, boolean toggle, set it to true. And there you go. So now we have our mesh. And just to be safe, we're going to unify the normals, if that was not already the case. And unify normals is a new component. It's under the mesh tab. Grasshopper right now has it default included, but it used to not be there. That's why I said in the beginning that it's better to install the mesh edit tools. But it's in a utility, and it's called Unify Mesh. And it basically does the same as this one, Mesh Unify Normals. And I believe this one is from the Mesh Edit Tools. But this one is from Standard Grasshopper, so let's use this one. Nice. So now we have our mesh, nicely set and done. Let me go to View, Display, and Preview Mesh Edges. so we can see what's going on. And you might wonder, like, how do we get to our hexagons from here? And that's quite easy, because there's a nice component in Weaverbird. And let me show you. It's called Weaverbird's Dual Graph. And this will get the dual of a mesh. So what it basically does is it connects the center points of the meshes to create a new mesh. So if I connect it, you see that there's a hexagonal pattern on top of the triangular mesh, let's say. So that's perfect. Then this is already like the hexagons that we want. But as you can see, there's some issues here, especially where the surface seam is. So let me turn off the hexagons for now, because first we need to fix this, because this is not ideal, and it has to do with the amount of V, apparently. There's some weird stuff going on. And if you take a look at the hexagons, you also see that they're rotated 60 degrees, if I'm not mistaken, because the pointy side points up, but in the end we want to have the flat side pointing up. But no worries, there's a small trick we can do to fix both these issues, and that's by reversing the surface direction. And the nice thing is, Lunchbox has a component that does that for us. So let's go to the Lunchbox tab, and it's located under Utility and Reverse Surface Direction. So we need to reverse our lofted surface, this one. So let's insert it. And the R, that's the mode we want. So 0 is do nothing. 1 is reverse only the U, 2 is only the V, and 3 is the U and the V. And that's the one we want, the number 3. So let's insert a number slider with 3. And let me reconnect the reverse surface to the surface here in the bottom. Like that. So now, as you can see, the panels are flipped around. So also we need to do something about the proportion, because now the U is going to be a little bit more than the V. So like that. Let me turn a wire component, be our wireframe, so we know where the seam is. Ah, yeah, here's the seam. So as you can see, because we reversed the direction of the surface, also the panels got reversed. And now we don't have the issue of a weird connection. The only thing is, if I set it to an uneven number, like 49, for instance, you see that there's some weird stuff here going on. And if I go to the dual, you see that it didn't got created. Also, the mesh didn't got welded, let's say. But the good thing is, if you look at the hexagons, they now have the correct orientation. So that's one problem solved. And the other problem is just to make sure that the U divisions is always going to be an even number. Now we can easily fix that by double-clicking on the slider and set the rounding to even numbers. And that's it. Now you can't even select if I slide here, it will always be an even number. So let me group this, Ctrl G, and just type here even numbers. So we know, as a reminder to ourselves, like, hey, these needs to be an even number. Nice. This component is basically the dir command in Rhino. If you type in dir, let me show you. If I put a surface like here, and I select it from direction, you can change the direction of the surface like this. So you can either do the reverse the U, reverse the V, or swap. The swap is basically the option we used, which is the number 3. So in the next lesson, I'm going to explain briefly what method Gehry Technology used to populate the surface, because it's a little different than the one we're going to use. in that lesson, we're going to use anemone. I'm not going to model anything in that lesson. I'm just going to show you the method they used. So if you don't have installed anemone, it's okay. Don't worry. You can just follow along and get a grasp of the different methods and the variables and the parameters Gehry Technology uses, because we're kind of going to use them also, but a little different, because we're going to use Kangaroo to do the relaxation of the panels. We'll take a look at that in the coming lessons. So see you in the next one.